Down beneath the deep blue sea, where one day I chanced to be, the mermaid gave a very swell affair. I looked out from my submarine at the queerest ball I'd ever seen. Not a soul on earth I knew was there. Of course they did the tango, and no one made a slip. Of all the guests assembled there, each one could do the dip. At the mermaid's fancy ball, in Father Neptune's hall, the little eels were pickled and they did an naughty wiggle. Although it shocked a few old crabs, it made the bluefish giggle. At the mermaid's fancy ball, they had no bar at all. But I didn't hear a sigh, for not a guest was dry at the mermaid's fancy ball. A mackerel who was sousy fed lay down in an oyster bed, which put the oysters in an awful stew. The clam stretched out their little necks, which made that mackerel very vexed. The things he said I dare not tell to you. But when the drumfish beat it, that was the worst of all. For without a drum, you know, it's very hard to give a ball at the mermaid's fancy ball in Father Neptune's hall. The blackfish did a cakewalk and it surely was the limit. A lobster turned quite red and said the tango isn't in it. But the queerest noise of all, I heard a codfish fall when Father Neptune, wise old guy, at a mermaid winked his eye. At the mermaid's fancy ball, at the mermaid's fancy ball, in Father Neptune's hall. The weak fish fainted dead away, creating quite a bustle. It made them very strong again when they were fed on mussel. At the mermaid's fancy ball, the sweetest thing of all. For dessert they served a dish of delicious jellyfish at the mermaid's fancy ball.